My Chinese lighter plug splitter seems to have an issue. Not sure if you can see the smoke coming off it. Sure you can. Looks like it's not quite the good thing that I pronounced it in my mailbag video. Guess I'll have to tear that down and figure out what the hell is going on. After only a week, my fancy little lighter socket power bar with switches and USB plug went up in smoke. Not really happy about that, especially after declaring it to be a good thing. Well, I guess let's find out what happened. The fuse is welded in there. That's cute. Wonder if it can come out in one piece. Oh, yeah. Okay. What else? Screwdriver. I keep forgetting this thing. The old guard of YouTube people keep telling me that they'll steal your stuff if you don't put your name on it. Yeah. I'm not really expecting anybody to want to steal my stuff, but just in case, there we go. Ooh. Oh, okay, that'd help. Okay. Here's the negative side. Oh, that's smelly. Well, there's the problem. Is that going to come out of here? Wow. Some serious meltiness. Well, there's the spring that's supposed to be behind the fuse. There's your problem. Oh, wonder why that went all to crap. Mr. Fuse, are you still good? That was really, really hot. Come back here. Yeah, fuse didn't die. Did I ever look at that fuse and check what it was? Of course, the markings on the other side. F5A, 5 amp fuse. And it didn't blow, even though it got stupidly hot. Well, I'm going to have to take a look around here and see if I can find another one of those. Because this part worked great. This part is disappointing. Well, that took longer than I thought. I don't actually have a lighter plug in my accumulation of bits and pieces. So, being as how it's springtime and a Saturday, I went to a yard sale and found this for 50 whole cents. It's a charger for some sort of a cell phone. Oh, that's interesting. A multi-charger. Doesn't matter. That's not what I want. But that's good. I remember these. Back in the day, every phone and every model of phone had its own proprietary stupid-ass connector. I'm glad we moved on since then, at least a little bit. So, cut the warranty sticker. How am I going to get into this thing? Well, that's promising. Okay. That launched. What we got in here? Some kind of a little buck converter, I'm guessing. Probably 5 volts. What's that chip have to say for itself? Not that I care, but you know. What are you? 3405. What? I know you can't see this. Well, maybe you can. It's no doubt just a standard little constant current buck converter kind of thing. But that's not important for what I'm doing. All I need is that and that. However, I will add this to my accumulation. Notice I don't call it a collection. A collection would imply that there's a goal to it and a plan behind it. And that's not what's going on here. So, how was this? Is there a fuse launched out of there somewhere? Maybe I can put my 5 amp fuse back into it. But obviously, that goes there, that can probably go there. Oh, get in there, you. That seems reasonable. Okay. So now all I gotta do is, danger, danger. There's a trap right here. I'm gonna take these pieces one at a time, not cut them both. Did you see the trap?
Yeah. Both wires are black. If I cut
one of them, actually, hey, is that going to fit in the same hole? I might not even have to cut that one off. Let's see now. Man, those things keep springing. Oh, that's nice. I don't even have to cut that guy off, so I just have to resolder that one. And I think I'm not going to try and solder to the spring because that's going to be annoying. I'm just going to join those two up and put a piece of heat shrink on there. But I'm going to pause while I gather some heat shrink and let the iron warm up. Alrighty. Let's get on this. It's actually very thick stuff. That's not bad. And actually, before I get carried away here, I'll untwist you. Shrink up there and out of the way. Come on. I could go and get a proper pair of strippers. But, nah, not worth the time and effort. Don't need that guy anymore. So as usual, tin both your work pieces, and then you just have to touch them together, heat them, let them cool without melting. So this is, one of those new sponges that I got in a previous mailbag. This is my old one that I've had for since I was a teenager, eons ago. No wonder these guys were so cheap, but I'm not, I don't know. I'll use them anyway, I guess. Just like that. It's kind of goofy, but so be it. Okay. Shrinky hinky. Dee dee dee. Using the Dollarama heat shrink tool. Notice I don't have it directly in the flame. I've got it just on the side of the flame. I don't want to scorch it or catch fire. I just want heat. Okay, that's that. Put helpy hands out of the way. So now then. There, get in there, you. Okay, that's that in there. Bring him a thing. That and that. So we're all in there. Wait. I need something else off of there. No, I don't. I need to strain relief that somehow. Go the low budget way. That needs to go about there. That's going to all spring out again. Had I been paying attention, I actually would have cut both of those and slipped a big piece of shrink on to strain underneath it, but that's not the way it's going to work. This'll get me there. It's not ideal, it's not pretty, but okay. Once again, that's got a lot of spring to it. That's good. The other thing that I'm going to do. Actually, yes. One other thing I'm going to do to strain relief that. Put a zip tie on it. Okay, so that springs back out again. Okay, what that's going to do is it's going to jam up against the end of the case there and not going to let them slide out. Right. What is this? The fourth time I've tried to reassemble this and then realized I was missing something. Okay, so there, that can't escape now. Dome hat thing, spring, big fat finger so you can't see what I'm doing. Ah! Come in. Oh well, this has been 10 minutes on this little section already. I'm going to have to do some editing, I think. Okay, that was a struggle, but I've won the fight. Got it back together again. There, that's better. Yeah, it's not drawing ridiculous on its current. Okay, and the blue lights come on, the middle one doesn't. Those two do, but that one didn't before. And where is my 5-volt test-o-matic here? Some kind of load. There we go. That works. Show me some voltage. Perfect. Okay, works again. So, let's see how long it lasts this time before I have to come back and re-repair it.